You're watching Camnet TV, not just another channel. Welcome to our news. The headlines: inflation reaches record high in 4 years. HH calls for serious reforms in the police service to deter killings. Government still deliberating on when to conduct the census exercise. In international news, AU UN peacekeepers do final patrols in Darfur. And in sports news, Spencer Sautu delighted to be recalled to the national team. For the details, join me shortly after this break.
Pastors Victoria and Moses Chilua, the Healing Word Ministries International, the board and management of Camnet TV would like to thank all the church members, the Camnet viewers, for your unwavering and failing support. Our prayers are with you all and the people of Zambia during and after this festive season. To those of us who lost our beloved ones, may the peace and love of God overshadow you. May His name Emmanuel be our comfort now and in future. We wish you all a peaceful, enjoyable Merry Christmas and a victorious, blessed, hopeful 2021. Pastors Victoria and Moses Chilua, the Healing Word Ministries International, the board and management of Camnet TV would like to thank all the church members, the Camnet viewers, for your unwavering and failing support. Our prayers are with you all and the people of Zambia during and after this festive season. To those of us who lost our beloved ones, may the peace and love of God overshadow you. May His name Emmanuel be our comfort now and in future. We wish you all a peaceful, enjoyable Merry Christmas and a victorious, blessed, hopeful 2021. Pastors Victoria and Moses Chilua, the Healing Word Ministries.
With the details, my name is Liseli Kanyanga. We begin our news on a rather sad note, where former gender minister in the MMD government and Zambezi East Member of Parliament, Sarah Saifwanda, has died. Ms. Saifwanda died in the Solwezi General Hospital in the early hours of Thursday after an illness. Until her death, Ms. Saifwanda was an active member of the opposition UPND as she served in the party's National Management Committee. Ms. Saifwanda will be remembered for walking from Chingola to Solwezi, along with the then former Solwezi Central Member of Parliament, Lucky Mulusa, in 2016 in protest of the poor state of the road. The late former minister, working with other cabinet ministers from Northwestern Province, prevailed over President Mwanawasa to have the M8 road tarred, which is from Mutanda to Chavuma. Immediately the PF came into power, Ms. Saifwanda was offered the deputy ministerial position by the late President Michael Chilufya-Sata, but she turned it down. The late former minister was a very close associate of the late former cabinet minister Mike Mulongoti. Let's just have a look back at the person who has passed away on this foul video.
Is this the one? Is this Tungola Solansi?
Chief Chikanta of the Tonga-speaking people in Kalomo District of Southern Province has urged traditional leaders to campaign against political violence in the country as the country rather enters an election year. He says traditional leaders are generally members of the public have a huge task in denouncing violence so that what the country has witnessed should not happen again. The traditional leader also says politicians should ensure that they campaign peacefully to allow members of the public to vote peacefully. He says being part of the National Anti-Violence Organization places him at a better place to publicly condemn violence perpetuated by anyone, especially political parties. Chief Chikanta has cited the 2011 elections as such, which did not record many violent activities, a situation he says should be emulated. Chief Chikanta was speaking to the media in Southern Province.
Some of you, you are stakeholders. 2021 campaigns, yes, it's a campaign year, and there would naturally be a threat of political violence. But what do we do as Zambians and also as traditional leadership? We must campaign against political violence. We must campaign against political violence so that you people can decide on 14th of August next year, you decide in peace who you want to vote for, not running away from violence. So it's actually government, the media, yourselves, and us traditional leadership, the church, to campaign against political violence so that we tell these political parties that we don't need violence. What we need is a peaceful election. It can be done in so many ways by so many stakeholders. Us as traditional leaders, we are ready to condemn political violence, and we will be involved. Chief Chikanta, I'm a member of an organization. We've had MVS. MVS is a movement for voter sensitization, MVS. It's a national organization which was officially launched in Lusaka in November, and it has branches in all the provinces. It has
United Party for National Development UPND leader Hakainde Hichilema has described the changes made by President Edgar Lungu as cosmetic, stating that the changes will have no effect on the promotion of rule and law in the country. Speaking at a media briefing, Mr. Hichilema also said the changes amount to nothing in restoring sanity in the service. Mr. Hichilema echoed his call for a thorough report on and appropriate measures on the death of state prosecutor Nsama Chipioka and a UPND member Joseph Kaunda. The opposition leader says the people of Zambia are in need of a police service that is approachable and not brutal to them. In the meantime, the opposition has welcomed fresh calls for political dialogue ahead of the 2021 general elections.
1st December 2020, we say goodbye to the year 2020, which has been described by many people as challenging. The country witnessed several social and economic challenges, which include high poverty levels, the COVID-19 pandemic, high rate of unemployment, inflation, and high debt levels, among other issues. However, towards the end of the year 2020, the country witnessed a sad incident where two citizens, Nsama Chipioka and Joseph Kaunda, were killed by the police in the process of dispersing United Party for National Development supporters who went to give solidarity to UPND leader Hakainde Hichilema when he appeared for questioning at the police headquarters, a matter that has annoyed many people. Following calls on President Edgar Lungu to act on this issue, the head of state has made several changes in the Zambia Police Service. However, the UPND leader feels the changes are cosmetic.
The citizens of Zambia demand for a full reform of the police system, to move away from brutal force to that same community, We don't expect cosmetic changes. We have had so many cosmetic changes in the past. The people of Zambia do not need that approach anymore. Too much blood has been shed. Innocent lives are gone, young lives are gone. We cannot continue with cosmetic changes in the police system. Fundamental changes must be instituted, like yesterday. Citizens must run to the police when they're the problem, not running away from the police when they're the problem. Because the police is the killing machine under the DF government. So we need a proper reform. Complete reform of the police system.
Says Zambians have endured hardships.
This must come to an end as we go into 2021. Zambians are enduring an economic hardship. The depreciation of the kwacha, high inflation, rising cost of living under the PF leadership is killing Zambians. It's not just the bullets, rubber bullets which are being abused at close range, live bullets, tear gas, so those are poisonous gases. It's not just that which is killing citizens. It is hunger. Many citizens are unable to afford 2 or 3 meals a day. They go to bed hungry. That's who is killing people. Diseases are killing people because the money meant for medicines in hospitals is being diverted to buying guns and tankers, as we saw on that Wednesday. This must come to an end.
In the meantime, the opposition leader has welcomed fresh calls for political dialogue ahead of the 2021 general elections.
Come for dialogue. We are available, meaningful dialogue. But we must implement the dialogue resolution, which includes ending violence, release of political prisoners, which includes stopping retiring people in national interest, yet it's in private interest in the public service, in the local government. Stop separating husband and wife by unreasoned transfers. You are hurting families, you are damaging families. Come to the dialogue table, you will find us there. We will not find you there because you drag your feet, you will find us there. But I want to encourage the church to walk an extra mile and make sure that from midnight tonight, they put in the process for that will be available, will be supported 100%.
Patrick Soko, Cabinet News in Lusaka.
About 20 United Party for National Development UPND supporters who were arrested on the 23rd of December 2020 when they went to offer solidarity to UPND President Hakainde Hichilema when he appeared before the police at force headquarters have appeared in the Lusaka Magistrate Court on one count of idle and disorderly conduct. Particulars of the offense are that the accused persons on the 23rd of December December 2020 in Lusaka jointly and whilst acting together whilst at a public place, namely along Independence Avenue, did conduct themselves in a manner likely to cause a breach of peace. Among the 20, 9 appeared before Magistrate Felix Kauma and 11 before Magistrate Albert Mwaba. More in this report.
Supporters of the United Party for National Development, UPND, made their appearance before the Lusaka's Magistrate Court this morning, the 31st of December 2020, on a charge of idle and disorderly person. The 20 accused were arrested on the 23rd of December 2020 when they went to offer their solidarity to their party leader, Hakainde Hichilema, who was summoned by the police for questioning. They were arrested during the time officers attempted to disperse UPND supporters. During this time, two people were allegedly shot dead in the process, Nsama Chipioka, a state prosecutor, and Joseph Kaunda, a UPND supporter. Among the 20 accused persons, 9 were appearing before Magistrate Felix Kauma and 11 before Magistrate Albert Mwaba, all charged with the same offense of idle and disorderly person, contrary to Section 178 of the Penal Code. The 9 accused persons before Magistrate Felix Kauma are aged between 35 and the youngest being a 17-year-old juvenile, while those before Magistrate Mwaba are aged between 30 to 45. The accused before Magistrate Kauma are Eddie Nawa, Sid Ngulube, John Welema, Nelson Banda, Wellington Mwanza, and Levi Muloa. The accused all pleaded not guilty to the charge and were each granted a 500 kwacha bail in their own recognizance with one traceable surety, and their case has been adjourned to the 18th of January 2020 for commencement of trial. Meanwhile, the 11 accused persons who are appearing before Magistrate Mwawa includes Akaland Katanga, Hambinga Mainza, Makoni Siwuku, Joseph Mbuzi, Edwin Chivo, Kamanga Simbilu, Peter Msoko, Briston Smuyendo, Charles Musonda, Ganizani Monga, and Christian Chipango. The 11 were also granted 10,000 kwacha bail each in their own recognizance with one working surety, and their matter has since been adjourned to the 11th of January 2020 for mention and fixing of trial date. Miriam Kemba, reporting for Kamni TV News in Lusaka.
Government says the preparations for the census of population and housing expected to be undertaken in 2021 is processing well. National Development Planning Minister Alexander Chiteme, who could not exactly say when the census will be held next year, explains that cabinet is yet to discuss and decide when is the best time for the activity to be held. Mr. Chiteme notes that the COVID-19 pandemic is one of the key determinants as to when and how the census can be held. The minister has attributed the country's failure to hold the 2020 census of population to the COVID-19, among other economic challenges. Zambia holds a census every after 10 years, to which the 10 elapsed in 2020. Mr. Chiteme was speaking at an end-of-year media briefing in Lusaka Thursday, where he highlighted the gains attained in climate change resilient programs.
Next phase, we took it to the Eastern Province, and the last portion is went to Muchinga, Luapula, and Northern Province. We are in discussion with the World Bank right now to include more provinces, Central, West, beg your pardon, Copper Belt, Northwestern, and parts of Western Province that were not covered in the earlier programs. We are also in talks with various cooperating partners so that we can bring intervention as close to Lusaka as possible. In fact, we have interventions that are in Lusaka. In Kafue Lower Basin, we have intervention in climate change that is part of Lusaka. So we are looking at every part of the country where climate change is affecting us. Yes, we are looking at doing the census in 2021. Cabinet hasn't sat to set a date when this census is going to take place, but we are hoping that it does take place. Considering what I mentioned earlier, we are having a second wave of COVID-19, and we don't know how vast it will affect this country. It's already ravaging South Africa, and very soon we might have our borders closed and get to a situation that we were in 2020. That will affect a lot of things, affect our lives, will affect our political lives, will affect our development agenda, will affect a lot of other things, and that could as well affect the census and maybe other things. So I cannot tell you today to say I'll hold the census on such a date unless we sit as cabinet and decide that.
Zambia has recorded a total trade surplus of above 215 billion kwacha for the period of January 2020 to November 2020, compared to about 170 billion kwacha recorded in the same period in 2019. This represents a 29.3% increment despite the lockdowns caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. Central Statistics Agency Interim General Kamuro Musupa Mulenga says the total value of exports via all modes of transport for the period under review was at about 127 billion kwacha. Mr. Mulenga says the road transport accounted for 91.8 billion kwacha, while rail transport was second at 9.7 billion kwacha, and air transport accounted for 2.8 billion kwacha during the same period. Other modes of transport accounted for 24.4 billion kwacha. And moving on in the news, over 200 houses in Kanyama and Maloni area of Chilanga district in Lusaka province have been flooded following a heavy downpour in the early hours of New Year's Eve. Disaster Management and Mitigation Unit, DMMU, National Coordinator Chanda Kabwe says there is urgent need to find a lasting solution to the perennial flooding situation in Lusaka. Speaking when he visited the flooded areas in Kanyama Township and Maloni area of Ward Chilanga District, Mr. Kabwe said DMMU, working with other government line ministries, will ensure rather that the flooding situation is addressed. Mr. Kabwe has called on the engineers from the local authority, water utility companies, and other officers from the Ministry of Health to work together to address the floods and the diseases that may break out. The national coordinator observed that waterborne diseases may break out in flooded areas because fecal matter from toilets have been swept and combined with drinking water in shallow wells, which he said should be quickly addressed. He attributed lack of planning as the cause of the floods, as most areas in Lusaka have no space for proper roads and drainage systems to drain away water. He says the country cannot afford to have an outbreak of cholera, as it is already grappling with the new COVID-19. Mr. Kawe says DMMU is ready to move in with the machinery to pump out the water and expect the local authority through the Lusaka Water and Sanitation Company to start supplying the residents with clean water.
I'm appealing to Lusaka Water to come on hand, whether by bringing water bowsers and supply water to the people. In terms of the extent to which the water has affected the people, for now, it's a small section of the people that have been affected. But if we don't deal with this matter now, it means the water will continue to flow and more houses will be submerged in water.
What is important now, I've given instructions that we get all those pipes that are required to help us pump out the water to the safe site. It's also important, DC and RC, that your people from health department, both in the local authority and the Ministry of Health, are here, are mobilized to ensure that we look after our people. You can see there are bitter trees already. The drinking facilities, the shallow holes that they use water for, will be compromised, and that will be a very bad part. We've done so well in terms of the vaccine for the cholera. We are told yesterday by the Minister of Health that we have a different strain of COVID or another type of COVID, whatever they're calling it. So combined, if we don't manage these rains very well, our health system may be overwhelmed. By yesterday, around 0102, I was told about 200 houses that have flooded, and I can see it for myself. So identify how many more that need the government support so that we come and give them the relief support. But overall, we need a permanent solution. The cost of responding to these issues could even be more higher and the cost of finding a permanent solution.
We take our first set of commercials. Do stay with us as we have more interesting stories lined up for you.
We all miss the days we would play outside, go to school, and visit fun places. But now,
We all have to take care to prevent the coronavirus. Viruses are really tiny particles that we can't see with just our eyes, so we need to keep ourselves safe by practicing good hygiene, such as washing our hands with soap and clean water regularly. We can also use hand sanitizer to keep our hands clean. It's also important for us to keep our bodies and surroundings clean. We must also avoid handshakes, hugs, and standing close to other people in public places. This is called social distancing. The coronavirus has affected millions of people around the world, so we need to stay safe. In the meantime, we can keep ourselves busy by reading a book, watching TV, and doing some schoolwork. There's so much we can do indoors. Stay safe, stay home, and prevent COVID-19. We're all in this together.
This advert is sponsored by the Zambia Revenue Authority, ZRA. My tax, your tax, our destiny.
From time immemorial, we have had different types of lighting options. From those that can burn down our investments in minutes, to those that dig holes in our pockets due to constant replacement and huge consumption of our Zesco units. Savenda Electric introduces the new and advanced electric bulb with cutting-edge technology of LED that has low power consumption, gives out bright white light, and lasts up to 25,000 hours. Savenda Electric manufactures all types of LED light, like plastic LED fluorescent tubes, downlights, ceiling lights, outdoor fittings, and solar street lights made to customer specifications. Let's live on the bright side of life by choosing the wide range of Savenda Electric lighting solutions that are available in all leading stores and supermarkets countrywide. For orders, call 0962-642-490 or email jnbunda@savenda.com or pchabula@savenda.com.
Dr. Bigron,
yeah.
Gift na land.
Which think you bet we be se mojo wasayone.
Mina mush, nakule teranjinga. Latest inaluvesi gear na mawaipa.
Difficult, tidi ashidi anjinga. Diamu 19 pendefcon. Transport, we got it.
Nanga phone for communication. Ipu sana chizungu. Yeah, you see what I mean?
It's a camerate, difficult.
It's communication, we got it.
Inemo mi! Powerful system ndimba ndimba. X-Buzz.
Mufumile kukalale na mnaimu muliba kumushi. We got it. Yo, Big Lord, utole no leta nche mfule mungani. Ngechi wachila pose na nishita chinshi. 1, 2, 3, both of you. Kabala ngempanga. Don't miss chop it. Ocho udigi ya chika dapa zeti. Emoji ya ndisula kumuko shine kwa tini tirene. We got it.
Yemi alade.
Can I have that meal over there? And I really want that crisp, fresh apple taste from the garden. Can I have a the apple?
I think I'll have my Big Bite 2 meal with a happy waziwaka. Give us your...
Enjoy an appetizing Big Bite meal with an happy drink of your choice. A meal is not a meal without an happy drink. And now introducing happy in a can.
Pastors Victoria and Moses Chiluwa, the Healing Word Ministries International, the board and management of Camnet TV would like to thank all the church members, the Camnet viewers, for your unwavering and failing support. Our prayers are with you all and the people of Zambia during and after this festive season. To those of us who lost our beloved ones, may the peace and love of God overshadow you. May His name Emmanuel be our comfort now and in future. We wish you all a peaceful, enjoyable Merry Christmas and a victorious, blessed, hopeful 2021.
Thank you so much for staying with us. We continue with the news. Democratic Party leader Harry Kalaba has warned entities and people engaging the governing Patriotic Administration in fraudulent deals that time to account wrongdoings is fast approaching. Mr. Kalaba is disappointed that most people are getting rich at the expense of swindling the nation through kickbacks by facilitating opportunities for some self-investors. Mr. Kalaba Calabar has vowed to deal with all those involved in capital fright when given a mandate to govern the country in 2021. Meanwhile, Mr. Calabar regrets that Zambians are being made spectators in national development in their own country, while those they chose to preside over their affairs keep enriching themselves. Speaking during the end-of-year media briefing in Lusaka Thursday, the opposition leader is disappointed that government has opted to give the running of Kanseli gold mine to foreigners when the local people can manage to run the mine.
Our commitment for a better Zambia, the DP interventions. The DP is a progressive party that does not believe in making empty promises to the people of Zambia, but rather seek to provide solutions that are transformational in nature. We are alive to the fact that empty rhetoric and the baseless promises are what has led this country to be where it is today. Therefore, we are calling upon every Zambian to resist those who come to seek public office with baseless claims and yet fail to demonstrate how they will address the economic malaise that this country is currently in. The DP government will provide the leadership that will, with 5 days of being sworn into office, address the endemic siege of state capture and therefore free up resources for more meaningful and accountable development to take place. Within the 5 days of being elected as president, we would link ourselves from being captured by the same business people. Same people, year in and year out. That is coming to an end. Because this country belongs to all of you. Rather than opting for expensive options that benefit a few through kickbacks, we will ensure that the procurement process is sanitized and rid of all corrupt elements. We will also work with international financial crimes units to follow the money and ensure that all those who are guilty of siphoning money from Zambia are brought to account.
Yes.
Similarly, we will make all possible efforts.
Zambia's annual inflation rate has hit record high in over 4 years. Inflation rate has reached a record high at 19.2% in the month of December 2020 compared to 11.7% in December 2019. Central Statistics Agency Interim General Musepa Mlenga has attributed the increase in the annual rate of inflation to price increases in food items. The annual food inflation for December 2020 was recorded at 20.2% compared to 16.8% recorded in November 2020. Inflation has been persistently above the central bank's target band of 6 to 8% for almost a year and a half and may accelerate due to the continued depreciation of the kwacha and a recent default. Meanwhile, the gross domestic product, GDP, estimates for the third quarter of 2020 has shown that the economy shrunk by 2.6% from a 1.1% growth in the third quarter of 2019. The contraction in growth recorded in the third quarter of 2020 is mainly attributed to the underperformance of 5 industries which posted negative contributions to overall growth. These were wholesale and retail trade, education, public administration, arts, entertainment, and recreation and the construction industry. And still in the news, the Road Transport and Safety Agency, RATSA, has warned motorists across the country against driving under the influence of alcohol during the festive season. RATSA Head of Public Relations, Frederick Mubanga, has told Kamna TV News that so far 15 people have had their licenses revoked and has warned that those found wanting also risk having their driver's licenses revoked. He said this will be done under the provision of the Road Traffic Act No. 11 of 2002 that permits RATSA to revoke driver's licenses of any person who is a danger to other road users. Mr. Mubanga further said intensified measures have been put in place to ensure motorists comply with the law. Mr. Mubanga says more traffic law enforcers from the Zambia Police and RATSA have been deployed to cover major highways.
Deployed quite a number of road traffic law enforcement officers jointly from the Zambia Police and the Road Transport and Safety Agency. And our officers are doing targeted enforcement, bearing in mind that we've got a lot of people that tend to drive at excessive speed, one. Two, those that drive under the influence of alcohol. Three, those that use the cell phone whilst driving. And four, those that don't use the seatbelts correctly. During this period, most of the cases hinges on issues to do with excessive speed, which is as a result of people also driving under the influence of alcohol. So we can report that so far we have, through the major street courts, suspended the driving licenses for over 15 drivers that were apprehended for driving under the influence of alcohol during this festive period. So this will be a permanent feature, because for one to drive under the influence of alcohol, definitely there's an aspect of disregarding traffic rules and regulations with impunity. Therefore, the carry-on call is to all road users that let's learn to respect traffic rules and regulations. Let's ensure that during this period we are very cautious, and also let's ensure that we take a personal conviction and pledge to promote and support road traffic accidents interventions that the country through RTSA has put in place. So let's also realize that there is life beyond celebrations, so let's celebrate in a mood that do not in any way affect the safety of you as an individual, and secondly, the safety of other road users. So we have also projected a very significant reduction in the numbers of road traffic accidents come end of 2020 as compared to the previous year, bearing in mind the interventions that we had put in during the 2020 period. And going forward, for 2021, we are put in place quite a number of road safety interventions, as well as trying to enhance our service delivery.
A 32-year-old bus driver accused of attempting to kill a police officer has been committed to the Lusaka High Court following instruction from the Director of Public Prosecutions. Albert Kawe of Lusaka's Makeni Villa area stands charged with one count of attempted murder contrary to Section 215 Cap A of the Penal Code. Allegations are that the accused on the 18th of November 2020 attempted to cause the death of Grace Walungu, a police officer. The accused appeared before Lusaka magistrate Albert Mwaba for explanation of the charge Thursday morning and was committed to the High Court for his trial proceedings. The court refused to grant him bail despite his application on account that he can only do that at the High Court. And moving on in the news, the Water Resource Management Authority, WAMA, has welcomed the decision by the Kalulushi Magistrate Court to convict Tongsin Metals Company Limited and its director for the offense of unlawful interference with the water course contrary to the law. The company and its director, Kennedy, were found guilty after they pleaded guilty to the charge, and the courts convicted them on their own admission. And in passing judgment, Magistrate Chandi observed that the cases of environmental degradation by corporate firms on the Sabina Road catchment have been rampant. This is due to several industrial activities taking place in the area, as evidenced by the number of cases being prosecuted by WAMA and the Zambia Environmental Management Agency, ZEMA.
Waste Management Authority, WAMA, has noted with great concern the increased encroachment of water bodies and discharging of toxic waste in the water bodies, contrary to the Water Resources Management Act No. 21 of 2011. As a result, the country has witnessed degradation of water bodies and catchment areas, resulting into loss of human and aquatic life and property in certain areas. The authority wished to reiterate its call to the general public to desist from building of structures within the riverbed and riverbanks, cutting of trees and clearing of vegetation within catchment areas. Such acts enhance runoff within a short period, leading to flooding as the carrying capacity of natural water bodies is surpassed. In this regard, the authority wishes to inform the members of the public that on Monday, 21st December 2020, the Karolushi Magistrate Court convicted Tongzin Metals Company Limited and its director for the offence of unlawful interference with a water course, which is contrary to Section 71H, as read with Section 163 of the Water Resources Management Act No. 21 of 2011 of the Laws of Zambia. The company and its director were found guilty of the offence after they pleaded guilty to the charge, and the court accordingly convicted them on their own admission. In passing his judgment in the matter, the Honorable Magistrate observed that the cases of environmental degradation by corporate firms on the Sabina Road catchment had been rampant due to several industrial activities taking place in the area, as evidenced by the number of cases being prosecuted by WAMA and the Zambia Environmental Management Agency, ZEMA. The court has since fined the company. In default thereof, distress may be levied on the company's property, while the director was fined. In default thereof, 9 months imprisonment.
We take our second set of commercials. Do stay with us as we have international and sports news. Don't go away.
Sabenda Group of Companies would like to thank the Zambian people for their overwhelming support and trust throughout its 23 years of business, especially during the challenging year of 2020. You have been our true friends and partners on this journey of saving nations and developing Africa, our motherland, which is what Sabenda stands for. As the Group CEO, on behalf of the board, management and staff of Sabenda, I would therefore like to take this opportunity to wish His Excellency Dr. Edgar Chagwalungu, the President of the Republic of Zambia, the Zambian people, our esteemed customers and partners, a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
You look so pale and busy scratching yourself.
Lamwandi, you know my skin is very sensitive. I've tried all the skin products and nothing seems to work.
Have you tried Oracle Pure Glycerin?
Oracle Pure Glycerin? What's that?
Just give me a minute.
Oracle Pure Glycerin gives your skin a youthful and healthy glow.
Ish! You're glowing.
Don't tell me.
Yes!
I already know the secrets.
Oracle Pure Glycerin!
Try Oracle Pure Glycerin for that perfect skin.
We all know how important good nutrition is to grow up big and strong. Not only is cowbell milk enriched with 28 vitamins and minerals, it's also boosted by the 5 most important vitamins, which we call VitaRich.
It's got vitamin A for good eyesight development. It's got vitamin C to help fight infections. It's got vitamin D and calcium to help build strong bones and teeth. It's got vitamin E to help with body protection. And it's got vitamin K for general well-being and immunity.
For good health and vitality, only Cowbell with VitaRich puts you on the fast track.
Pastors Victoria and Moses Chiluwa, the Healing Word Ministries International, the board and management of Camnet TV would like to thank all the church members, the Camnet viewers for your unwavering and failing support. Our prayers are with you all and the people of Zambia during and after this festive season. To those of us who lost our beloved ones, may the peace and love of God overshadow you. May His name Emmanuel be our comfort now and in future. We wish you all a peaceful, enjoyable Merry Christmas and a victorious, blessed, hopeful 2021.
Thank you so much for staying with us. We continue with the news. In international news, African Union and United Nations peacekeepers in Sudan's Darfur region are carrying out their final patrols as the 13-year mission officially comes to an end. Following a peace deal with rebel groups in October, the Sudanese government is to take over security in the region where hundreds of thousands have died since conflict broke out in 2003. About 500,000 people still live in displacement camps in Darfur. Attacks in the region are still common and many civilians are concerned about the imminent pull out of peacekeepers. A spokesman for the mission said the UN would still be present in the country and would continue to support the Sudanese people.
Thousands of people, mostly displaced women and children in the Darfur region of Western Sudan, staged demonstrations on Sunday against a decision by the UN Security Council to end the mandate of the 2007 established United Nations African Union mission in Darfur peacekeeping force and replace it with a smaller political mission. Its withdrawal, expected to be completed by June 30th, could create a security vacuum in a fragile post-Bashir region with several active militia groups. At least 15 people have already lost their lives in inter-ethnic clashes since the announcement, forcing authorities to deploy more troops.
We now get into sports news. Power Dynamo's midfielder Spencer Sautu says he was excited to be named in the Zambia national team for the 2020 Africa Nations Championship CHAN, which starts on January 16, 2021. Sautu, who will be making his second appearance at the Continental Edition, says he is proud to represent the country. Sautu says he never expected to be included in the team, considering that he has been nursing an injury for a long time. The midfielder has been in fine form in his first season in Deke as on loan from Green Eagles, and fields Monday's All-Stars versus the Fans select side also helped him claim a spot in Mitchell's 31-man squad. He has since assured the Fans that he will not let them down, as he is now determined to help the Chipolo Polo do well at the CHAN. The Chipolo Polo boys are currently in Morocco for the CHAN Nationals tournament. That sports item brings us to the end of the news, but before we go, a recap of the headlines. Inflation reaches record high in 4 years. HH calls for serious reforms in the police service to deter killings. Government still deliberating on when to conduct the census exercise. And in international news, AU UN peacekeepers to do final patrols in Darfur. And in sports news, Spencer Sautu delighted to be recalled to the national team. The Camnet TV World Verse of the Day is coming from the book of 1 Samuel 7 verse 12, and it reads, "Afterward, Samuel took a stone and set it upright between Mizpah and Shen. He named it Ebenezer, explaining, 'The Lord has helped us to this point.'" On behalf of the entire news production crew and myself, Liseli Kanyanga, thank you so much for watching Camnet TV News on Camnet TV, not just another channel.